You've heard the term infopreneur, right? Like, it's probably a thing you've heard of. And it is actually something I would consider myself. I would consider myself an infopreneur. But what is an infopreneur? And how do you establish yourself as one? I'm going to tell you today. It doesn't matter how you say it, it's an actual word, whether Google thinks it is or not. People use the term infopreneur, it's a thing. And while you're here on my channel, you're watching an infopreneur. Basically, anybody who teaches anything on YouTube is an infopreneur, because an infopreneur is someone who runs a business by teaching other people how to do something. So if anybody teaches how to do anything on any platform, they are an infopreneur. So while you're here on my channel, listening to my infopreneurness, wondering how to be an infopreneur, then you should probably hit subscribe so I can teach you more about infopreneurship as an infopreneur on YouTube. Okay, so like I said, infopreneurs teach people how to do things. They make their money by teaching people how to do things. They are not necessarily a service-based business. They're definitely not a product-based business, but they teach for a living. So if you have an e-course, or you want to have an e-course, or you follow people who do this, or you follow people who are teaching for free, they are infopreneurs. But this whole, like, how do you become one, or how does that work? The biggest thing I have to tell you is that infopreneurs all focus on content marketing. They are constantly creating free content to teach their audience, who then learns from them for free and wants to pay them to learn from them more. So that is kind of the premise behind their marketing plan. Most infopreneurs are highly, highly focused on creating a lot of content and putting it out into the world. Now, a service-based business owner or someone who's product-based, that may not be their sole marketing focus, but an infopreneur, it totally is. Now, to be a good infopreneur, if you hear nothing else from me, you need to teach to people in a way that is easy to understand. You will never, ever be a good infopreneur if you can't teach to people in a way they can understand. I always say, explain it to a five-year-old. If you can't explain it to a five-year-old, you don't know it well enough to teach it. So a lot of times I will see, especially like in my Facebook group, video editors will get in there, or, you know, people who have been filming video for years and they're all in their technical jargon and all this stuff. And someone will ask a simple question like, how do I embed a video on a website? Or how do I change the size of an embedded video on a website? And they go into this like big, long, drawn out like process of changing the aspect ratio and whatever, when really all these people needed to know was that they have to change the size of the video, and here's an example on how to do that. You have to break things down really easily, and then you build on that platform. You build on that foundation. So to be a really good infopreneur, you need to be able to explain things really, really simply and easily, and then be able to build on those simple and easy foundations to create more and more complex teachings and lessons and whatever. So if you're wanting to be an infopreneur, if you're wanting to be someone people come to learn something, know that you can't go into it with technical speak and crazy kinds of jargon, because the people who are coming to you to learn don't know any of that yet. You have to teach them those words and that stuff. So a really good example of this, when I was working at my corporate job years and years ago at this point, I had a friend in the engineering department, and he would come in and he would talk to us about, you know, like we had an issue, so we'd have to call him, or he wanted to tell us about something, so he'd come in and tell us, you know, how he fixed something or whatever. And he was an engineer, and he was a true engineer, and he was an amazing engineer. But when he talked about engineering things, my eyes glazed over, because I didn't understand the words he was using to talk about it. So it wasn't making any sense to me. So I would say, hey, listen, I want you to explain this to me, but I want you to dumb it down about 10 levels. And he would, and he completely could tell me what he was meaning. But if he just naturally came out with what he wanted to say, it came out with all these like engineering terms that I didn't know. They weren't in my vocabulary. So you have to treat your people not as if they're stupid, but as if they're a beginner, as if they don't know these things yet. You can't just say, oh yeah, change the aspect ratio on X, Y, or Z when they don't know what that means. So you have to bring it down a couple levels and make sure you're meeting people where they are. And most infopreneurs teach things on a leveled system. So they might be teaching, you know, beginners and then intermediate and advanced, and that's okay. That's a great way to do it. So, are you an infopreneur? Hit me up in the comments and let me know. If you are not, let me know who your favorite infopreneur is. I'd love to hear it. And then make sure you hit subscribe because I don't want you to miss any more of my infopreneur. Bye, y'all.